This is Edward. Edward is filling out thousands of copies of the same PDF form by hand. He then sends every single PDF form in an email attachment to the recipients from his Excel list one at a time. It's an exhausting job, and it's difficult to keep track of whether or not all of the emails have arrived. He would like to automate it, but he doesn't have much time, and he doesn't know how. Don't worry, Edward, we've got a solution. In this video, we are going to show you how you can use our tool MailMergic to automatically mail merge thousands of PDF forms with the data from your Excel list and send these to thousands of different email recipients in just a couple of minutes. In our example, we show how to mail merge a student application form with data from a fictitious list of applicants. Go to MailMergic.com and create a free account. After you've created your account, you will be redirected to the home screen. Your home screen probably looks a bit empty, so let's just create a new mail merge with a click on Create Mail Merge. In the first step, drag and drop or click the box to upload the PDF form you want to use as a template. It does not matter whether the PDF has interactive form elements or not. As soon as the PDF file has been uploaded, you will be navigated to the second step. Here, you can upload your Excel file. Make sure that the relevant data is on the first sheet of your Excel workbook and that each column has a column heading. After uploading the Excel file, the editor is loaded in the third step. Drag and drop the placeholders on the left side of the screen onto the PDF file. The placeholder names result from the column headings of your Excel file, which will later be replaced by the data from the corresponding Excel column. If no or incorrect placeholders are displayed, you can adjust them by clicking on this link. Here, you can see an excerpt from your Excel sheet. Select the row in which the column headings are actually located. With a click on Change Header Row, the placeholders are regenerated accordingly. Now you can drag the placeholders to the desired position and adjust the appearance, such as the font size or font family, using the toolbar. You can click through the pages of your PDF file at the bottom. With a click on Preview, you can see which data the placeholders will be replaced with later. Make sure everything is shown correctly before going to the next step. Once you've added all of the placeholders as desired, click Save and Next. In the fourth step, you can see how many credits will be used for the mail merge. Below, you can create further settings for the file names, such as the output options and the email template. Let's have a look at all the settings in detail. In the first section, you can specify a custom file name for the generated PDF files. You can also use variables to access data from your uploaded Excel file. You can define a variable by typing the character @ and selecting the corresponding column name from the drop-down menu. If your Excel file contains more column names than can be displayed in the drop-down menu, enter the column name after the @ sign to narrow the selection in the drop-down menu. To delete a placeholder variable, simply click on the X and it will be removed. In the next section, you can adjust the output options. Choose whether you want to download the output files as individual PDF files or as one large combined PDF file. You can also choose whether existing interactive form elements, such as text fields, radio buttons, and so on, should be removed from the PDF files, or if these should be kept. If you're not sure what to choose, we recommend that you keep the default settings. In the following section, you can enable the password protection option. This ensures that the final PDFs are secured and accessible only to those with the correct password. The first field lets us set a password required to open the PDF. We can enter a fixed password or use placeholders to personalize it for each recipient. For example, using last name, secure 1234 means each recipient's last name will be part of their unique password. The second field sets a password required for making changes to the PDF, such as editing or printing. This ensures that recipients can view the document but can't modify it without the correct password. For this demo, we won't actually set a password. So let's clear both fields before proceeding. In the last section, you can specify whether you want to send the PDF files as an email attachment to a recipient list from your Excel file. To activate this feature, click the switch. First, we will define an email address from which the emails will be sent. Click on Add to add a new email address. After you have entered the email address, click on the Request Verification Code button. You will receive an email to the address just given. This email contains a 4-digit code that you should enter here. This ensures that only you can send messages from your own email address. In the From Name field, you can enter your name or that of your company to help recipients recognize you in their inbox. In order for the name to be fully displayed in email programs, it should not be more than 50 characters long. Next, select the Excel column that contains the email addresses of the recipients. When you select a column, we automatically check if the cells in the selected column contain a valid email address format. Please note that we just check the format, not whether these email addresses actually exist. In the next two fields, you can enter the subject line and the content of the email. As with the custom file name, you can also enter the at symbol to select a placeholder variable from your Excel file. You can also use simple HTML markup for the email content. When you are done, save your email template. A new PDF document is generated for each row in your Excel spreadsheet. Make sure you have enough credits available. The Always Free plan comes with free PDF files per month and can be easily upgraded if you require more PDF files. After selecting the Validate Excel Data checkbox and clicking Generate PDF Files, MailMergic's AI automatically scans your uploaded Excel file for inconsistencies, highlighting any potential issues. AI looks for typos in names and addresses, invalid email formats, incorrect zip codes, and other common data errors. Here, you can see that some email addresses are invalid and other fields contain errors as well. This helps you catch mistakes before they cause issues in your final documents. To fix these errors, simply correct them in your Excel file and re-upload it to MailMergic before generating the PDFs again. With AI data validation, you can ensure accurate, professional documents without the hassle of manual checks. Wait a few seconds for the mail merge to complete. Click the button to download the completed PDF forms. The downloaded zip file contains all PDF forms as individual files. Let's move on to step 5. You can trigger the sending of the emails here. Wait a few seconds for the emails to be generated. As soon as the first emails have been sent, the delivery report of the mailing is displayed. The report updates automatically every few seconds. A green check mark means that the email was successfully sent to the recipient. A yellow warning sign means that the email could not be delivered, for example, because the recipient's mailbox is full. We will automatically try to deliver this email again. A red error sign means that the email could ultimately not be delivered. A possible reason for this could be that the email address does not exist. Please note that undeliverable emails are always due to problems on the recipient's side. If necessary, clarify with the recipient whether the email address may contain a typo. If you are sending to a large number of recipients, the mailing may take a while. You can close the browser window and come back to MailMergic and track the current status on the home screen later. You can find the link to MailMergic in the description below. If you leave a like and a comment on this video, we'll give you a free month on your subscription. Thanks for watching and see you soon!